Hey there! Welcome back to the Axure RP tutorial series. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to use style effects to create a button that takes on different styling when it's in various interactive states, such as being moused over or clicked on. To get started, drag a button widget onto the canvas. In the Interactions pane, click Mouse Over Style Effect. In the block that appears, check the Fill Color property and select any color you like. I'm going with lavender. Notice that the button widget changes colors as you make your selection. This is just a preview. The button will return to its default color when you close the mouse over block. In the web browser, the mouse over style effect is triggered when you move your mouse cursor on top of the widget. When you move your cursor off the widget, it returns to its default styling automatically. Let's test that out now. Click the Preview button at the top right of the UI to open the page in your web browser. Mouse over the button to change its color, and then mouse off again. Now let's give our button a mouse down style effect. The mouse down style effect is triggered in the web browser when the mouse button is pressed down on a widget, such as when you're clicking or dragging. Back in Axure RP, select the button and click New Interaction. Scroll down to the Style Effects section of the dropdown and click Mouse Down. In the block that appears, check the Fill Color property and select a new color. I'm going to go with green this time. Preview the page and test out the new effect. Next, we'll look at the Selected Style Effect. This style effect is triggered when the widget is in its selected state, such as when a checkbox is checked. Checkboxes and radio buttons have interactions built into them that set their selected states when they're clicked, but other widget types don't. To use the selected style effect with our button, we'll have to create an interaction that sets its selected state. First, grab the selected style effect in the New Interaction dropdown, and choose a new fill color like we did with the previous two effects. Then click New Interaction again, and choose the Click or Tap event. In the action list, click the Set Selected Checked action. Choose this widget in the Target dropdown, and choose Toggle in the bottom dropdown. This interaction will toggle the button between its selected and unselected states when you click it. Let's test this out in the browser. Clicking the button once should show the selected state's color. Clicking it again should remove that color. The last effect we'll discuss is the disabled style effect. Like the selected effect, the disabled style effect requires that the widget be set to its disabled state with an interaction. It's worth noting here that users can't interact with disabled widgets in the browser. Disable a text field to prevent users from entering text, or disable buttons to prevent users from clicking them. Back in Axure RP, set up the button's disabled style effect with a gray fill color. Then click New Interaction and select the Context Menu right-click event. Select the Enable Disable action and target this widget. Select Disable and click OK. Preview the page and right-click the button to disable it and turn it gray. Notice that now that it's disabled, the button's other style effects are no longer triggered. Head over to docs.axure.com for more learning resources and start exploring. Thanks for watching and happy prototyping.